Jenny, Jenny, who can I turn to? You give me something I can hold on to.
My name's Bart Herbison, Executive Director of the Nashville Songwriters Association. And in the Tennessean, this Sunday's story behind the song is the great Alex Call. My friend, it's good to see you. Where did you first start doing music? Because you came from a rock and roll background before you hit Nashville.
Yeah, I grew up in Northern California, just north of San Francisco. Right. And
in the cool days, too, I might add.
Yeah, you know, I was on Haight Street in 67.
God, I wish
you know?
I could have been there, man. I finally got over there in the 90s. What was that like, man?
It was incredible, actually. It was absolutely incredible for about a year. But by the time what they call the Summer of Love,
right,
it was over. It really was. It was really the year before. It was like 67 into 68.
Did you meet some of the cool people? Were you playing? I'm going to spend five hours talking to you about that.
I had a band there called Clover. We started right then with John McPhee, who's now in the Doobie Brothers.
Right.
Later on, Huey Lewis joined as our harmonica player. And we were a great band. I mean, we were a great band. But, you know, in those early days, in the Panhandle, which is part of the Haight, they just had open concerts. You know, there'd be Janis walking around and, you know, Jerry Garcia. And everybody was like, hey, man, we're all family.
Look at my jaw.
Yeah.
So, you've got a band, and you mentioned Huey.
Yeah.
You were part of that.
Well, I was the founder of the band with John McPhee, a great guitar player, plays with the Doobies all these years. Had a band called Southern Pacific here for a while.
Oh, that I know.
Yeah.
Another one.
So, Huey joined the band in '71, and we made a couple albums for Fantasy Records. Then we went to England in the mid '70s. And made a couple albums for Phonogram Mercury, and we were actually the band on Elvis Costello's first record, My Aim Is True. We were the band.
I didn't know that.
Huey and I didn't play.
You're killing me.
I heard that stuff the day it was recorded. John McPhee brought this old tape recorder down to this big house we were living in.
I never knew that.
Yeah. I heard Elvis Costello sing, and I went, I'm doing this all wrong.
And you had success here, but this piece for the Tennesseans called The Story Behind the Song.
Yeah.
And we've got a book, 867-5309, Jenny, the song that saved me. Now, this is one of those songs that you play the first few riffs and everybody knows it.
Right.
And how did it come about?
You know?
Who was she?
Unfortunately, the real story is quite boring. I was just a songwriter thing. You know, I was sitting on this bench under a plum tree in my backyard in Mill Valley, California, and I started playing. It's 10 in the morning, you know, so it's time to write a song. And I just came up with this number. I don't know where it came from. It came out of the blue. And
it sings. I don't know that there's another number that would sing like that.
It's also a prime number. It's a bunch of stupid stuff. I mean, the legends of this song are many. Okay.
The urban myths.
But I know, but my favorite one, because for a while I've done a lot of shows across the country in the last few years, and I've taken like a sampling with the audiences to ask how many women have used it as a brush off number. It's many, many thousands. Okay. So that's my favorite one. I mean, there's lots of stuff connected with the song.
But back to the song, did you finish it by yourself?
I wrote the riff. The number, the name, and everything. I had this little steam-powered four-track studio in this little industrial yard, and I went up there and I recorded the track and everything, and I got kind of ran out of steam about 3 p.m. and I had the track done, and then Jim Keller, the guitar player for Tommy Two Tones, showed up, and
aren't you glad he did?
Yeah, and he just said, I said, I don't know what it's about, and he goes, it's a girl's number on a bathroom wall. We went, ha, 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 you know, that's funny. That'll really get cut by Eddie Money. But, you know, we finished the song and it was really fun. And then the next day I tried to write a real song. But eventually it got on their record and it wasn't supposed to be a single. It was back in the days when DJs still played tracks off of records and it took off. And, you know, it was on the charts for a year. And you know, it's just stayed there over the years. When it came out, one of my favorite ones was a newspaper clipping. It was a high school in Paducah, and they got 50,000 calls in a week. Is Jenny there? You know. So, I don't know. It's just a song that's, you know, for some reason connected with people. And, you know, I think it, you know, that term, the zeitgeist, you know, it was kind of the spirit of the age of the early 80s. You know, it's just one of those songs. It's number four on One Hit Wonders and VH1 every year.
I love that.
We can't bump Too Shy and Come On Eileen yet.
Kaja Goo Goo and Dexy's Midnight Runners.
Okay, you're a better man than I am, Bart.
Jenny, I got your number. I'm gonna make you mine. Jenny, don't change that number. It's 675309. 875309.